السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ مائی ڈیئر اسٹوڈنٹس مے دا پیس اینڈ مرسی آف اللہ بی اپان یو آل ٹوڈے ویل اسٹڈی چیپٹر نمبر 17 دا فاسٹنگ ان وچ ویل کور مینی آسپیکٹس لائک ڈیفینیشن پرپز بینیفٹس آف فاسٹنگ سو اینڈ سو فورتھ سو ناؤ فسٹ آف آل واٹ از سام آف فاسٹنگ دی فاسٹنگ از ون آف دا فائیو پلرس آف اسلام اینڈ فاسٹنگ ڈیورنگ دا منتھ آف رمضان از ابلیگیٹری and it requires a person to abstain or keep oneself away from eating, drinking and the relationship relating to marriage from dawn until sunset. See, dawn is the time in the early morning when daylight starts appearing before the sunrise. And fasting is not compulsory on the sick and the traveler or old people, those who are too weak to observe it. And women with their infants, like the young babies, those who are fully dependent on their mothers to survive. So these people can make up their fast at a later time whenever it is convenient for them, for the days that they had missed due to some genuine reasons. So now we'll discuss the purpose and wisdom behind fasting. So it is fasting is intended to teach us discipline. A good discipline and self-control, because when we are able to overcome our basic desire for food, water and other temptation, then it gives us assurance that we can master any temptation throughout the year until the next Ramadan, and it also helps us get closer to Allah in our submission to Him, and it also trains our soul, and it also trains us to be more patient in our life, and moreover it also produces in every individual the feeling of compassion towards the needy, because when we feel hunger, our mind makes us realize the pitiable condition of the poor, and we become more inclined to help them, and finally it also ensures us to get a good and healthy body. So now I will discuss some benefits and merits of fasting. So whosoever fast and stand in prayer during the month of Ramadan will have all his past sins forgiven. And in the month of Ramadan, the gates of paradise are opened and the gates of hell are closed, and the devils or shaitan are chained, and the minds are ready for the righteous deeds. So now the true spirit of fasting. We cannot simply ignore the spirit of fasting, because it holds no value in the sight of Allah's Messenger when he says in one of the hadiths that if one does not give up lying and acting by it, then Allah doesn't require him to give up eating and drinking. Another hadith says that many of the people who fast but gain nothing from their fast except hunger and thirst. And finally, the greatest reward that we would get out of fasting, it can be referred to this hadith, which says in that Allah Almighty says that fasting is for him and he himself will directly give the reward to his servant. So this way Islam teaches us that we can change ourselves for the better during the month of Ramadan through fasting. May Allah bless us all with the highest degree of enthusiasm to attain the purpose of fasting, and may Allah accept it from us to please Him and make us successful in this life as well as in the hereafter. Ameen. Jazakallah khair, and thank you very much for being with me for this chapter. So see you again in the next class.